Hello, thank you so much for clicking my video. Today's wig was sent to me from Nazula Hair. The direct link to this wig will be in the description box, as well with their promotional links they have going on this month, plus a coupon code. And on the back of the box, it comes with care directions for your wig. The wig came packaged in that clear plastic baggie. They were also kind enough to send this really pretty ombre edge scarf and a wig cap. Here is a close-up of what the inside of the wig looks like. You get a 5x5 HD lace parting space, two combs in the front, another comb in the nape area with adjustable straps. The hair texture on this wig, I would say, is on the silky side, and it's a body wave 24-inch wig. When I received the wig, it came as a middle part, but you can go ahead and change the parting space if you want to the right, middle, or left. The hairline comes just a little bit pre-plucked, and the knots do not come bleached. Here's what the wig looks like straight out of the box. I'm going to keep the styling on this very simple and beginner friendly. First, I'm gonna go in with this hot comb. I got this hot comb from Galaxy Girl. If you're interested in it, I will leave the link below. This is actually just a little bit more hotter than the Andis hot comb. And the temperature that I have it on is 330. I think later on I go in and turn it up to at least 450 though. The highest temperature on here is 450. First, I go in and press down the parting space and then the hairline. I'm going to go in with the Erica J Frizz Belief Wax Stick, and this just helps lay down the flyaways that's at the top of the closure part of the wig. I would like to add two temple hair baby swoops, so I'm just taking out the baby hair from now, and then I go in with the hot comb and press down where I would like my baby hair. This just help lay the baby hairs in the direction, so when you swoop it, it's already laying in that direction, if you get what I'm saying. I like to use eyebrow scissors to cut off my lace, so I just take my scissors and cut right along the hairline. Underneath the lace, I went in with Maybelline Fit Me Powder. The shade that I have is 355, and I applied my powder in a T, so I just applied it to the hairline and the parting space. Now it's time for the install. I kept the waves in the wig because I didn't want to do too much customizing, so it can be more beginner friendly. Right there is where I hooked my adjustable straps. I'm about to install the wig. I forgot I had my bonnet on. Sorry about that. I'm going in with a brown nude stocking cap underneath the wig. You could go in with brown, you could go in with nude, you could go in with black, whatever works for you. I list like brown nude stocking caps because it helped the parting space pop up more like scalp. I applied some makeup powder to the parting space and hairline. This just helps hide the lace a little bit more. And just a reminder, on the hairline, I didn't go in with any gel, glue, spray to tack down the lace. It is just sitting on my forehead. Right here's my end results, and I tried to keep it beginner friendly as much as possible. I didn't want to do too much work because I know a lot of people is not good at customizing, but they still want that virgin hair look and they still like the body wave that come with the wig. So I didn't want to do too much and wash the wig out and bleach the knots, and then you guys are like, that's not how the wig came. So this is just the option on how you can wear the wig. You could definitely go above and beyond and pluck the hairline some more, wash the wig, redo the curls, whatever you like. This is just optional. So stay tuned for my thoughts on the wig. If a harsh wind blow outside, this is what the hairline would look like. Hey you guys, how are you doing? I hope you said you're doing good. If you made it to my end results, thank you so much for tuning in and getting here. This right here is my end results. I hope you like. I want to do something very easy for you guys, and especially if you're a beginner but you want like that virgin hair look but you don't feel like going through all that styling, I thought this would be a good idea to do. At first, I was going to go in and customize this wig, pluck the hairline some more, bleach the knots, curl it. But I was like, let me make this really beginner friendly. So again, this wig is from Nadzula Hair Company. Thank you so much, Nadzula Hair, for sending me this wig. I have worked with this company in the past, and I must say they have some really good quality hair, and I recommend. I don't see bad reviews on them that I know of, but if you need more details about them, you can always check them out on social media, and you can always type their name in on YouTube to see other reviews from other people, especially people that's not sponsored. I know there's people out there that actually buy their hair. All right, so if I look down, don't mind me, I'm on my phone. I wrote down questions to answer for you guys, just in case I missed something, because it's been a while since I recorded. I took a little break, so my mind is just a little blank. So I want to make sure I don't miss no details for you guys. So, do I recommend the company? How is their customer service? From what I know, when I email Nadzula Hair, they reply back really fast. Like I said, I worked with them in the past. The shipping is pretty fast to New York. I'm not sure where they're located. I'm not sure if it's in China or somewhere else. But shipping usually takes no more than 3 to 5 days with them, business days. And I like that a lot. The texture of the hair is on the silky side. It's very soft. Really nice, really cute.
Do the hair have a high luster or low luster? So I do not have any product on like the lower half of the hair. This is how the hair come, and I feel like the luster is very low. I like it. It doesn't come off shiny. It's really nice. As for the top of the hair in the crown area, I had to go in and apply product, which was the Frizz Bully Wax Stick by Erica J, and I only did that just to smooth out the top and get rid of those flyaways. And one thing I love about this product that I say all the time compared to other wax sticks is it's not heavy on the hair. Sometimes when you have like a super heavy product, it makes the hair look really oily and bad, but the luster on top matches the luster on the bottom. Like I said, there's no luster on the bottom with me using products, so that's really good. When I received the wig, did I have an odor? This wig is straight out of the box, most likely. I did not go in and wash it. When I received it, it do not have no foul odor. It do not smell burned. It has a smell, but nothing that's annoying. The smell is like, you ever got like Milky Way hair out of the beauty supply store, but it has like this certain smell to it? That's exactly what it smells like. I don't feel like it's a bad odor or a strong odor, so I feel like you could rock with it. Did I wash the wig? What are the products I use? I did not wash the wig. A lot of people recommend, you know, when you get virgin hair wigs, it's good to wash them. But like I said, I just wanted to do something that was beginner friendly for people that want the virgin hair look but don't want to do that much work. But later on, in order to keep your wig like good and keep going, I recommend washing it every two weeks, depending on how dirty it gets to you. It's really up to you. And be careful with your hair, because you don't want it too dirty and then your hair is like touching your face. So, you know, that could cause breakouts. Be careful. Did I get shedding? When I was running my fingers through the hair, playing with it to add some more volume to the waves, my fingers is going right through. I'm not getting any tingling. As for shedding, I'm not getting any shedding either. But I am using my fingers, so, you know, it's not going to really pull out too much shedding. And I don't want that, because sometimes you run your fingers through wigs and you get a lot of shedding. But from what I'm experiencing so far, it's good. It's really good. What kind of lace does the wig come with? Is it easy to blend? So the lace that comes on this wig is Swiss lace. It's very soft. I'm not sure if it's Swiss or HD, because the way it blend, you would have thought it was HD, so I'm not sure. I'm gonna leave all the information to the wig that I have below in the description box, but the lace blends are really good. And what I love about it that's super beginner friendly is the fact that you don't have to go in and glue it every day. I do not have the hairline glued. It is just sitting on my forehead and it blends perfectly. You could add your little baby hairs in the front, so when the wind blow, you got a little something, you know, looking cute. I feel like the lace is definitely workable. You don't have to go in and bleach the adjustable straps. Bleach the adjustable straps, y'all hear me? Yeah, I don't have to go in and bleach the knots on the wig. I feel like you could go ahead and hide it with powder. That's why I like to use powder, because powder just looks more natural to me, and it's more easier to hide the knots in the grid with the lace. So that's one reason why I use powder. Can the hair handle heat? To me, it can definitely handle heat, because when I went in with the hot comb, I put it on the highest temperature. Plus I added product. So it was just like melting the product right into the hair, and the hair wasn't melting. It was good. I definitely feel like it's beginner friendly. This one is for the beginners. This is for you, booze. I do have other 5x5 closure wigs that I have coming. And those, you know, I'm going to go in and customize a little bit more. You guys know I love some customizing, getting it supernatural. So this one is for the beginners, and you can always go in and customize it more. You don't have to keep the body wave. You can go ahead and wash it, curl it, dye it, whatever you want. As for the density of the hair, if I'm correct, I think the density is 150%. I'm not sure, but the density is perfect to me. I love it. Really nice. Not too thick, not too thin. Love it. But if you guys have any questions, feel free to comment below and I'll get back to them as soon as possible. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was helpful. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Later, you guys.